A very warm good afternoon to all of you. Dear students, I welcome you all in digital class of biology. Students, as you all know that soon our unit test will start. So for that, we need to revise the chapters which we have studied so far. So today I'll start with my second chapter, that is sexual reproduction in flowering plant. But before that, dear student, I would like to say something to you. Students, whatever problem you are facing in your life, don't mess with it. Don't rehearse with it. Okay? Just hand it over to Lord Krishna and he will reverse it. Dear student, I repeat, he will surely reverse it. So believe on him, okay, and keep doing your karma. So with this beautiful thought, I would like to start with my today's chapter, that is sexual reproduction in flowering plant. Clear? Student, this is the mind map of your this chapter. Okay, so I'll take it one by one by making it zoom, okay, so that you can visualize it carefully. Okay, so I'll start with here, from here. So student, this is the name of the chapter, that is sexual reproduction in flowering plant. First of all, what we had studied in this, we had studied about the flower structure. Okay, we had studied that your flower consists of two parts, that is essential and non-essential part. Essential part consists of your female part, that is pistil, and male part consists of your stamen. Clear? And stamen in turn consists of your anther and filament, whereas pistil consists of your stigma, style and ovary. Okay, and about non-essential parts, it will be your sepal and your petal. Okay, a group of petal is known as corolla, whereas group of sepal is known as calyx. Okay, a group of stamen is known as androecium, whereas group of pistil is known as gynoecium. Clear? I hope so that you know everything about flower structure. Clear? Then after that, in this chapter we had studied about pre-fertilization event. Okay, as you can see here, pre-fertilization event, okay, means those event which will occur before fertilization. Okay, so what are the event? Student, these are the event, okay, that is the formation of male gametophyte and formation of female gametophyte. Okay, student, what is this? It is the TS of your anther. Clear? Remember that this is stamen, okay, and this is anther and this is your filament. Okay, so we had cut this in transverse section and now I can see this in this way. Clear? Inside it there is formation of your pollen grain, and pollen grain are known as male gametophyte. Clear? And inside it there are male gamete which will fuse with the female gamete. Clear? After that, student, there we had studied about the development of female gametophyte. There we had studied about pistil, okay, and then this is the enlarged view, okay, of stigma, okay, and these are fused carpels, okay, and then student, what is this? This is your ovule, anatropous ovule, clear, and inside it, you can see embryo sac. Just I'll mark it, this is your embryo sac. Okay, this embryo sac is known as female gametophyte, and inside it there is egg, or I can say ovule. Understood? Student, after that we had studied about pollination. Okay, after that we had studied about pollination. In that we have studied that pollination, okay, it is of three types, that is autogamy, geitonogamy and xenogamy. Okay, after that we have studied that your xenogamy, okay, it is a type of your cross pollination which involve agencies. Those agencies can be your abiotic or it can be your biotic. Okay, in case of your abiotic, it is wind. Okay, pollination by wind is known as anemophily. Pollination by water is known as hydrophily. Okay, pollination by animal is known as zoophily. Clear? After that, they have given some example. Okay, that is ओके विंटर पॉलिनेटेड ग्रासेस ओके एंड वाटर पॉलिनेटेड वैलिसिनेरिया एंड हाइड्रिलिया एंड इंसेक्ट पॉलिनेटेड प्लांट इज योर यूका. क्लियर? देन स्टूडेंट आफ्टर दैट वी हैव स्टडीड अबाउट आउटब्रीडिंग devices. What are these outbreeding devices? Okay, these are the devices for promoting cross pollination. What is this cross pollination? It is the transfer of pollen grain from anther to stigma of two different flowers. Clear? Student, here what happen? First of all, pollen release, okay, and stigma receptivity not synchronized. Okay, stigma will not receive the pollen grain. Okay, then what would happen? Production of unisexual flower, only one flower would be there. Clear? And after that, arrangement of anther and stigma at different position. Okay, and then there would be, because this anther, okay, the pollen grain which are there in your anther, okay, it does not receive any chemical secretion from the stigma, and also, okay, the arrangement of anther is different from the stigma, and it is difficult for the pollen grain to move from that position to the stigma. Okay, so all these things leads to self-incompatibility. Self-incompatibility means, though one flower contain both male and female part, but the arrangement of anther is such that it does not allow self-pollination. Clear? Student, after that there is pollen pistil interaction. Okay, what is this? It is a dynamic process involving pollen recognition followed by pollen tube growth. Okay, when your this pollen grain will receive chemical secretion from your stigma, okay, and that time it will fall here and it will grow a pollen tube. Okay, as you can see here, and from this pollen tube your male gametes will move to fuse with your ovule. Clear? And after that, in this only there is artificial hybridization. What is this artificial hybridization? Student, it is one of the major approaches of crop improvement by using desired pollen grain for pollination. Okay, here, okay, I can desirably remove the pollen grain of the, or I can say anther, from one flower when I want that other pollen grain to be fused with it. Means I can produce my own desired flower. Okay, and it is achieved by your emasculation and bagging. What is emasculation? Taking out of the anther, okay, with the help of forceps. And bagging is what? When once we have taken out this your anther, okay, stigma is there, we will put here some bag so that any other pollen grain should not fall it. Okay, with the help of your wind pollination or your insect pollination. Okay, so here afterwards I will insert my own desired pollen grain, okay, according to my own desired, means what kind of flower I want. So it is done by human beings, that is why artificial hybridization is the term. Clear? After that, student, there is double fertilization. Okay, and this is the topic for your this unit test. Okay, you need to study about double fertilization. What is this double fertilization, student? When your syngamy and triple fusion, they will combine together, okay, or they will occur simultaneously, it is known as double fertilization. What is this syngamy? Another term of syngamy is fertilization. What is fertilization? When male gamete fuse with female gamete, okay, here female gamete is your ovule, at that time it will produce zygote. Okay, whereas what is triple fusion? When one of the male gamete, okay, it will fuse, okay, with your polar nuclei and it will form endosperm. At that time it is known as triple fusion. Why triple fusion? Because here two polar nuclei are there, okay, and then one your male gamete will become here, and there will be triple fusion of three nuclei. So that is what is known as triple fusion. Clear? Because two type of fertilization occur in your plant, that is what is known as double fertilization. Clear? After that, student, post fertilization is there. What is post fertilization event? Those events which occur after fertilization. So you know what are the event occur. Student, first of all, there is development of embryo. Okay? first zygote would be there and then your embryo would be formed. Okay, this is a kind of your dicot embryo and this is a kind of your monocot embryo. This diagram is important. Okay, after that development of seed. Clear? Seed would be of two type, that is albuminous seed, also known as endospermic seed, and non-albuminous seed, also known as non-endospermic seed. Now what is this endospermic and non-endospermic seed? Student, when little bit endosperm remain, okay, in your seed, it is known as endospermic, and when it is used fully by the seed, okay, to become fruit, then it is known as non-endospermic seed. After that, student, what is there? Development of endosperm. What is this endosperm? It is a kind of food, okay, that is taken by the embryo, okay, to become seed. Okay, and how this endosperm formed? When your one of the male gamete fuses with your polar nuclei, which are present in your embryo sac. Clear? It will lead to the formation of endosperm. After that, student, formation of fruit. Fruits are also of two types, that is false fruit and true fruit. What happen in case of your false fruit? When part other than ovary contribute to the fruit formation, okay? And example of this is apple. Apple is a kind of your false fruit. Why? Because its development occur from any other part than the ovary, and the edible part of your apple is thalamus. Okay, the thing which we eat, that is thalamus. Next is, student, the fruit when it develop from the ovary, it is known as true fruit, and example of this is mango. Clear? And student, last topic of the chapter is special modes. Okay, how it occur? It occur by three ways, that is apomixis, polyembryony, and parthenocarpy. What is this apomixis? Here there is production of seed without fertilization. Okay, then second, polyembryony, as the name suggests, polyembryony, occurrence of more than one embryo in a seed. And third is a parthenocarpy, development of fruit without fertilization. Apomixis is, student, production of seed, whereas parthenocarpy is development of fruit. Clear, student? And last is significance of seed dispersal and fruit formation. Okay, student, what happen is seed dispersal help the species to colonize in other areas, and many fruit have mechanism for dispersal of seed. Okay, so here I have given you the mind map of your sexual reproduction in flowering plant. Clear? I hope so that you have understood. Okay, now I will take your important topic. Okay, that is fertilization, or I can say double fertilization. Okay, but here first we need to know something about fertilization. Okay, in case of your plant, okay, fertilization, we use different term, that is syngamy. Okay, so what is this fertilization? We all know that it is a fusion of male and female gamete to produce zygote. Okay, this is your male gamete, this is your female gamete. When they will fuse, they will form zygote. Okay, and zygote is your diploid. Why? Because it has double set of chromosome. Clear? And the pollen grain produce the male gamete, I have told you, and this pollen grain is your male gametophyte, whereas embryo sac is your female gametophyte. It produces egg. Okay, student, male gametophyte, it is a kind of home where your male gamete survives, okay, or lives. And embryo sac is also your female gametophyte where your egg lives. Okay, so embryo sac is the home of your female gamete. Student, fertilization. Okay, for fertilization we need that the pollen tube, okay, should enter your ovule in order to fuse with the ovule. Okay, so entry of pollen tube, it is of three type, that is porogamy, mesogamy, and chelozogamy. It is very important question for your MCQ type. Now we need to know that what is porogamy. Student, porogamy is that when your pollen tube enter through the micropyle. Okay, you need to know the proper labeling of your this ovule. Clear? So this is your micropyle, and when your pollen tube, this black is a pollen tube, when it will enter through the micropyle, it is known as porogamy. Very important for your MCQ. Okay, second is, student, mesogamy. What happen? when your pollen tube enter through the integument, these are integument, no, outer and inner integument. I hope so that you remember the labeling of this ovule. So when your pollen tube will enter through it, then it is known as mesogamy. Okay, integument, mesogamy. And student, last is your chalazogamy. When your pollen tube, okay, will enter through your chalaza. We know that this is micropylar end and this is your chalaza end. Okay, so from here it will enter. Getting? Important student, it is easy to remember. Chalazogamy means enter through chalaza. Porogamy from micropyle and then mesogamy. Mesogamy through integument. Remember these things. So students, what happen in this case, in case of your fertilization, okay? First of all, pollen grain, okay, it interact with the stigma, okay, of the pistil. I hope so that you remember, this is stigma, this is style, and this is ovary, okay? And what are these? These are antipodals, okay? This red one is your egg, and these two are your synergids, and these two are your polar nuclei. Clear? You need to know about this. So student, what will happen, this pollen tube will formed from your pollen grain, okay? After that, this, okay, your, actually we know that your pollen grain consists of your vegetative cell and generative cell, okay? Vegetative cell will form your pollen tube and generative cell will form your male gamete, okay? It will form two male gamete, okay? And remember that, okay, pollen tube contain two male gamete, okay, which are formed from your generative cell, okay? And your pollen tube is formed from your vegetative cell, which is present in your pollen grain, okay? After that, see here, these blue color structure are your male gamete. After that, see here, what happened? Now it enter through the micropylar end, so it is porogamy. Okay, entry of pollen tube through micropylar is known as porogamy. Okay, student, sometime division of your generative nucleus can occur inside your pollen grain only, or sometime it can occur in your pollen tube also, okay, to form male gamete. Understood? And after that, see, it is coming to fuse with the ovule. After that, student, what will happen? Okay, this is the thing to jot down, that one male gamete will fuse with the egg nucleus, okay, to form the diploid zygote, whereas another male gamete will fuse with the polar nuclei to form a triploid endosperm nucleus. Clear? So this is known as syngamy, and this is known as triple fusion. Okay, so now after that, what will happen? Here zygote will form, and here your endosperm nucleus will form, which in turn will form endosperm, and this endosperm will provide nutrition to the zygote, okay, to become seed, to become embryo and then seed. Clear? And this process is known as double fertilization. Clear? So here it is just the summary, just go through it. Student, what happened here? Okay, the pollen tube releases the two male gamete into the cytoplasm of the synergid. Okay, after that, pollen tube releases the two male gamete into the cytoplasm of the synergid. One male gamete fuses with the egg cell and produces zygote, whereas, okay, it is known as diploid zygote formation, and this zygote will develop into embryo. Whereas other male gamete, it will move toward the two polar nuclei located in the central cell. This is your central cell, and fuses with them to produce triploid PEN. Okay, that is primary endosperm nucleus. This central cell forms primary endosperm cell and develops into the endosperm. Okay, I hope so that you have got. Okay, so with this, I finish, okay, my first question or my first topic, okay, of your second chapter, that is sexual reproduction in flowering plant. Student, but if still there is any query, please feel free to call me. Thank you and have a wonderful day ahead.